You see it? Boom. Yeah. See, general, right here. So, hold on. Let me set this. Let me. All right. You see? Boom. Oh, man. Yeah. It's good talking to you, Jimmy.
Go on, brother. Yeah.
You want to say something before we start the interview?
No, I'm not a member. They think we could have remember how to say hello in French. I'm not a member again.
You see, man? Boy, if, all right. The man, they plan to learn French. That means, say, in plan to come here, so you know. On, you're the live and direct in a Paris city, all right? Big up yourself. Yeah, man. The real warrior up your so you know. Come, you know you. All right, we don't know each other personally, right? We never met in real life. But I know you a long time. Because I used...
Yeah,
I,
man. From about 2009.
You see, from Paul talking them time, yeah? Yeah, you see, yeah, man, it? All time. Right. So, since them time, yeah, me see you, I grew up as a son and a son killer, you know? And you go up on the battlefield a lot, you know? And me like, all I clash them when you done, me I listen to the audio and me say, yeah! Some kind of real battle ago and, you know, real fight.
Yeah, man, whole heap of war, you know?
All right.
Almost probably about 20 of them or something like that.
All right, let me ask you something. Before we dive into the clash with Soul Supreme and that, I would like to ask you, how do you prepare when you have such clash?
Well, kind of, it really, usually I don't really have much to study, being that I listen to all the sounds that, like, pretty much every audio will come on. I listen to, I'm pretty familiar with pretty much every zone that's active in the clash arena, so it doesn't really take a lot of studying. It's more of just preparing how I plan on attacking them, you know, the angles that I plan on taking. It's more really of that, you know, and kind of maybe studying some songs that I could counteract or, you know, stuff like that. But the preparation is more within myself, like just getting back familiar with my music again. Because when I'm not clashing, sometimes I would take a break from my dubs a little bit, you know?
Yeah, I see. So when you have a clash, it's like you dive back in your box, you get back the connection with the tune. And since you listen to Wagwan, you kind of know if it have changed, because sometimes the pattern of a first round, the curve you're going to put in a first round might not be the same that the one we used to put 10 years ago, you know?
Yeah. And what's been happening lately with me is I clash a lot. So lately, excuse me, lately I've been having to, you know, switch up some juggling and add some new stuff. And, you know, so my next few clashes. So probably for the next 6 months or so, people are going to start hearing a lot of newer music from me and a lot of stuff that I don't normally play, you know, because, you know, the last few years I've been using the same stuff to, you know, go to events. So looking forward to the future. People can look forward to hearing some different things, you know.
Yeah, man, it's a good look, you know, because you always have to upgrade and, you know, evolution, you see, is the key. Straight.
Yeah, man.
So I like that, you know.
For sure.
For sure. So you've been clashing a lot lately, man. What's going on, man?
Yeah, man. That's what it's about, you know. You know, it don't make no sense to sit down and just have all these dubs and not war, you know.
You see.
So we clash. Yeah. So we take on the clash. Them big song, small song, it no matter. We go out and we war, you know. Cause we do it for fun, you know.
Yeah.
We do it for competition.
Yeah.
You know, me personally, we do it. We love the competition, right? And we love. I love to entertain people, you know? So,
yeah.
As long as the people them still are roll out, you can always, you know, say Jimmy Spliff have a dead for clash.
And what about you? Love it. You get a lot of fun doing it, right? I mean, you enjoy yourself, right?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, definitely. The competition and you know, putting on entertainment for the fans, yeah. That's the feeling. That's the best part.
Winning
is fun, but you know, the best part is the actual event itself. When you're getting the forward and people are cheering or laughing.
True.
You know.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the best part of a clash for me.
All right, talking about forward and getting forward. The clash start, you see, and two songs that play, you and Soul Supreme, right? And it a go on wicked from first round. damn. I was like, yeah, it's hot. Beer forward, beer things are gone. But it seems like, all right, we depend on the Facebook Live, so we can't judge from a Facebook Live, you know, from an audio, right? But from what we see on the Facebook Live, it seems like you took the first round.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty clear to most people that I outplayed them the first round. And even the first vote that they did, I had more hands. I don't know why they didn't call it the first vote. If you're watching it, you'll notice.
For whatever reason, the first vote,
neither one of them would say what they saw. Right. You know?
Definitely.
And it was clear that I had more hands. It was clear that everybody knew that I played better than them in the first round. But
let me tell you something. You see, I've seen a lot of clashes and stuff. Every time they revolt, it's fuckery. The people don't like it. You know? They don't like no revolt. You vote, period. Let it go. The MC have to do his work properly. You know, you have to know who people have voted for. Else you can't. Sometimes. All right, but first round, you know, so we don't look nothing. Then the battle start and it was fire. Bah! Beer things are going, you know. But all right, from your perspective, you know, because you clash a lot of big sound lately, and some people say the strategy, you know, of being a warrior like this and going to every song, but without really getting the victories, they say that will be a problem for the brand. So I don't know what your views on that.
Views on what?
On the fact that if you go clash too much and you don't get too much victories out of the clash, it will hurt the brand, the Kingshine brand as a brand. You know, some say.
So where was those same people when I just won six clashes in a row?
Yeah.
So is this people just talk? Because people just talk shit.
Yeah.
You know, but people don't know what they're talking about. So I don't really care about when people say that.
So I want to ask you something, because do you see that since you've been clashing a lot, you know, your name is getting up, right? So you get more fans, no? I mean, that could be the answer, right? You get more fans. Each and every clash you do, you get
each more. And every clash, each and every event, you get more and more fans and more and more, you know, get more and more recognition. And I mean, what more could I want?
Yeah,
I've clashed in how many different countries?
Yeah,
I'm about to clash in England. I've clashed in many places in the Caribbean. I've clashed all over the United States. What more people want from me?
Yeah,
I couldn't ask for more. Mm-hmm. You know, I just find it hilarious that people who are not even at the level that I'm at are gonna try to tell me how to navigate it. They've never been here, so they couldn't tell me what to do.
You
see, while I'm here. You understand what I'm saying?
You see, yeah, I remember that from the early days, because you from Partner, nobody could have tell you nothing, you know. The man there is a real warrior, and you can't tell him nothing. When him have a decision that you they go for it, he's not coward, you see it? He's a real fucking warrior.
Put it like this. The formula that I used to reach where I'm at, they would have told me that's not going to work neither. You understand what I'm saying? Mm. So where would I be if I listened to them then?
Yeah.
I wouldn't even be where I'm at. Understand what I'm saying?
So, all right, you know what? I'll use an example, because I remember Black Cat back in the 90s. Well, Black Cat struggled sometimes, you know? But they never give
up. It's not about just remembering. It's not just Black Cat. It's every sound.
Yeah.
There's no sound that was out that was just winning every clash. It doesn't happen. No, there's no sound that was out that was just came out and winning every clash. It doesn't happen.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen. You have to lose. So that's just how it is.
That's how you learn.
Don't say, I've won way more clashes than I've lost. So all those people who try to talk this narrative about a loss, so what? Where they at when six clashes in a row? Where were they at? You didn't find them. Those same people didn't come and say, big up Jimmy, y'all go on wicked. So I don't want to hear them when I lose. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, man, definitely, man. That's good. All right, you just mentioned that you're coming to clash in England. Oh, boy. You know. You ready for the world right about now? Because yesterday I was on War Report, big up the youth them from War Report. And actually, he got umpire, you see, on an interview, you know. So, yeah, umpire seem ready, you know, him ready for the war too, up in England.
Oh, yeah, I didn't even know that. I didn't even get to see that. I didn't realize.
I'm here to tell you, you know, because this is Clashology. I'm keeping you up to date, you know. This is Clashology. This is the media about clash, you know. We talk it. Let me tell you something. You're coming to England. Do you have like, do you listening what's going on over there? Like the clashes in England, because you know sometimes England have some set of tune where them like to hear, and you know.
Yeah, man, we're always music and music, brother. You know what I mean? I say music and music. You know, I look to go over there and do anything different from that now I'm out, you know?
Yeah.
Music and music. Yeah.
Is it? Yeah, go bring your box over there so and I bust you on same way. All right.
See.
All right, can you remind the people the date of this clash?
It's April 25th.
April 25th, yeah, man.
It's at the O2 in Oxford, England.
England. And it's against Empire. You see it? So, yeah, you know, fear if you go clash Sunday in their own land, you know. In their own yard, no. in them own turf.
We clash anyway, brother.
Anyway, you ready for the world. Anyway, you hear that, promoters,
anyway,
you know. Yeah. All right. So, all right. I heard that you came up on Facebook and you say you're listening to the clash in France that happened in France the 25th of January, which was Platinum Cartel against Guiding Star, right?
Yeah.
So
the
what?
Tour City Clash.
Yeah, Tour City Clash, man. The country clash.
Yeah, I liked it. It was a nice clash. It was a nice clash.
But talk your mind. I don't want to hear nothing like that. I want to say, all right, what do you think about this French song, Guiding Star?
What I think about the what?
Guiding Star. You heard about Guiding Star, right?
Yeah, I've played with Guiding Star before in Paris.
Mm.
You didn't even realize I've been in Paris. I've played in Paris before.
Yeah, man. A long game.
Yeah, I've played in 2017. I was in Paris. I played with Ride the Vibes, and then I played with Guiding Star also.
Yeah.
So Maria Guiding Star, man. Jacob Guiding Star, bad soul still.
Yeah, man. A long time, yeah. Some from France, you know. They have a lot of foundations, too.
Yeah, they go to Canada too.
Yeah.
And do them thing too. Lock off and sound up there. So Maria them still.
Yeah, I like it, you know, cause nowadays it's hard in Sons Clash world, right? Because you need to bust the sound, and sometimes I see a lot of promoters, they put in on clash, you know, but they see the crowd, we kinda like some crowd sometime in the clash, you know. You see? And the people are wait for the stream on Facebook and them things, yeah, you know. Sometimes I don't know, man.
I mean, well, some of these dances when you see that don't have a crowd, well, at least here in America, it's because the dance don't really make that much sense. Meaning, like, it's not a dance that the people want to see.
Yeah.
It might look good on paper.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But nobody's asking for it. So even though it might look like a good clash between two level sounds,
yeah,
it's not something that the public want to see. So they're not going to come out just because... Or you putting on a clash. But when you take a clash now and you put two sounds with somewhat of some type of rivalry, something, you know, something there in between it.
Yeah.
And you know, then people will come out, you know?
All right.
People come out for it. Like I haven't played on a flop clash in a long time. You know?
Yeah.
And then that's just because I've been put on the right clashes. It's not because I'm more special than anybody else. It's just that the promoters are finding the right opponents that make sense.
Yeah.
You know? And
no, but you
dances.
I mean, you're right about that, because sometimes you have a lot of clashes happen between songs. It's good on the flyer, but there is no rivalry between the songs. There is no story. There is no nothing. It's just like good on the flyer, right? And the people want to see some kind of real war.
People like to see what they feel. People want to be entertained, man. You know? People want to be entertained. And sometimes, you know, they say styles make fights.
Yeah.
So you can have two good sounds, but you ask yourself, what kind of sound? Like, if you got two sounds and the both other sounds play slow and play slow rhythms, and you put those two sounds up against each other, it might be boring.
Yeah, true.
You know? True. But if you take two sounds and one is an up-tempo sound and one is a slower sound, And you put those two sounds together, it's two different styles. So maybe you get something more exciting. You understand what I'm saying?
So
that's
just an
example.
Yeah, you need to look up for the musical style and also the rivalry between the songs, which part
everything.
They come from,
yeah,
and thing. Everything.
Yeah, it has to be, you know, you can't just take two sounds and be like, okay, they both got music. I'm going to put them up against each other.
Yeah,
the style of how they play and all of that makes, you know, makes a difference.
Yeah, man. True. This is really important, you know. Yeah, man. So, all right. You just told me early on that you plan to, you know, bring some new type of music. I guess you have a lot of dubplate today, right? Because, you know, sometimes sons come to me and say, boy, you know, I had the Clash the other day. But when I dig in the box, I can only play like 80 tune in the Clash. But I have like 1,500 dubplates, you know?
Yeah.
So, you know.
Yeah. This year, I'll be playing some different selections, you know, than normal.
When you hear that, you know. Am I going to play some new selection? You see it? All right. Bon appétit, King Shine. You see, enjoy your food, man. I saw we stay in France, you know, we have manners. You understand? All right, my brother. Listen. You know, it's been good talking to you, man. You know, I'm glad to see you going on for the square. You see, you're a wicked son right about now, you know. So, yeah, me see you in England anyway. You see, ready for empire, right? You have any message to send to England?
Yeah, man, big up the whole of England. Them don't know England, I'm a place. The whole of London, Birmingham, you know. But big up the whole of France, man.
Yeah, man.
You know, I
can't wait to return. They are like, seeing.
I'm 17, I look for far away back.
You look for far away back. All right, not saying nothing, you know. We're going to set up something, seeing. Because so we stay our friends. We love the wah sound of friends, you know. We're not coward.
Yeah, man. That's
give thanks, my brother. Seen? We talk soon, right?
All right,
big up, big up, big up, big up, big up.